टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू चैप्टर 1 स्टैंडर्ड 8 रेशनल नंबर्स। रेशनल नंबर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज रेशनल नंबर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू सम बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट रेशनल नंबर। सो बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग रेशनल नंबर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज नेचुरल नंबर्स। द फर्स्ट इज नेचुरल नंबर्स। यू लर्न इन प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड अबाउट नेचुरल नंबर। व्हाट इज नेचुरल नंबर? नेचुरल नंबर इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 1 एंड गोज टू इन्फिनिटी, इज कॉल्ड नेचुरल नंबर। इट इज डिनोटेड बाय, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल एन, कैपिटल एन। सेकंड इज होल नंबर, ऑल्सो होल नंबर्स यू हैव लर्न इन प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड। होल नंबर इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 0 एंड गोज टू इन्फिनाइट। And it is denoted by, and it is denoted by capital W. Third, integers. Integers, in the integers included all minus values zero, one, two, three, and infinite. That means integer includes all minus values, all plus values with including 0, and it is denoted by capital Z, capital Z. So this is 3 basic points about rational numbers. Now this is main point, our main point, rational numbers. A number which has p by q form, where p and q are integers and Q does not equals to 0. That means Q does not equals to 0. So this is rational number. we can take an example about rational numbers like 1 upon 2, where p is equals to 1 and q is equals to 2. 3 upon 5, where p is equals to 3 and q is equals to 5. 0 upon 4, where p is equals to 0 and q is equals to 4. All of these are rational numbers. तो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज जीरो जीरो इज रेशनल नंबर और नॉट. जीरो इज ऑल्सो रेशनल नंबर्स. रेशनल नंबर हाउ जीरो इज रेशनल नंबर. We can write 0 is 0 upon 4, 0 upon 9, 0 upon 5, etc. Then the answer will be 0. 0 upon 4 is equals to 0. 0 upon 9 is equals to 0. 0 upon 5 is equals to 0. Then we can write is 0 is also rational numbers. So about our next topic is properties. What is properties? Properties about numbers or rational numbers. First property, our first property is closure property. Closure property. Closure property. So in this case we learn about closure property for addition. First, closure property for addition. Closure property about addition says if we add any two rational numbers, if we do addition of two rational numbers, a by a upon b plus c upon d, we can consider it a upon b is first rational number and c upon d is another rational numbers, then answer will be a rational numbers. Rational number. How? Let's check by taking some examples. Okay, how it is possible? 1 upon 2 is rational number. Second, another rational number we can take it 5 upon 2. You can take another any of example of rational number. Then add both of them to denominator are same, then we can take it common to an addition of numerator. Then answer will be 5 plus 1 6 by 2. Then 6 by 2 also a rational number. That means if we do addition of any two rational numbers, then answer will be also a rational numbers. This is closure property about addition. You can take any other example of rational numbers to verify this closure property for addition. Second point is subtraction. Closure property for subtraction. Let's check and is subtraction. Subtraction says A by B minus C by D, same as addition. A by B is rational number and C upon D is also another rational number. Then answer will be also a rational number. Let's check with some example. Verifying for closure property of subtraction. Example. Five upon three minus one upon three is equals to. Denominator are same, then we take it common and subtraction of numerator. 5 minus 1 is equals to 4 upon 3. So 4 upon 3 is also a rational number. Then it is verify. You can take another any example of rational number to subtract. Closure property for subtraction you can verify it by taking another example. You can take different numerator rational number, then also it answer will become a rational number. So third closure property for multiplication. Closure property for multiplication. Let's check. Closure property of multiplication says A by 2 multiply C upon D. Here A upon B is a rational number and C upon D is another rational number. Then the answer will be AC upon BD, means multiplication of numerator and multiplication of denominator. Rational number. We verify by taking some example. Let's 1 upon 4 multiply 5 upon 9. 1 upon 4 is rational number and 5 upon 9 is also number. In the multiplication of rational number, we have learned in previous standard what will we do. Multiplication of numerator 5 1s are 5 and multiplication of numerator 4 9s are 36. Then 5 upon 36 is also a rational number. So it is verified that multiplication multiplication of closure property is comes answer will be a rational number. Four number. By division mein closure property for division. Closure property for division. A upon B divide by C upon D. Then answer will be a rational number. let's verify by taking some example. Two upon four divided by one upon four is sign of division. Division is equals to 2 upon 4 multiply and reciprocal of 1 upon 4. What is reciprocal? 4 upon 1 is equals to 4 to the 8 upon 4 1 the 4. Then 8 upon 4 is also a rational number. So division, multiplication, addition and subtraction, all of them are closer property for these rational numbers, and answer will be all of them is rational numbers. So next, our next topic, next property is second is commutative property. Commutative property What commutative property says? First we check about for addition, commutative property for addition. Let's check what is commutative property for addition. It is A plus B is equals to B plus A. Let's understand by some example. If 2 plus 3, where 2 is equals to A and 3 is equals to B, or 3 plus 2, 3 is B and 2 is 1, then answer 3 plus 2 5, and 2 plus 3 plus 2 also 5. Then the answer will never change if we take any sequence of them, A plus B or B plus A. You can check and verify by taking some another example. So this is commutative property of for addition. A plus B is equals to B plus C. Answer will be same if you can take any side of A plus B or B plus A. And for second, for subtraction, what is subtraction of commutative property? A minus B is not equals to B minus A. Let's check. Three minus two is equals to A minus B, where A is equals to 3 and B is equals to 2. 3 minus 2 is equals to, answer will be 1. And 4, B minus A. What is our B? B is our 2. And what is our A? 3 minus 3. And answer will be minus 1. So it is not verified m minus b is not equals to b minus a, because answer of both sides comes different. So it is not verified a minus b is equals to b minus a is not verified. So we can write it a minus b does not equals to b minus a. Next, commutative property for multiplication. Commutative property of multiplication says a multiply b is equals to b multiply a. Then let's verify by taking some example. 5 multiply 2, where a is equals to 5 and b is equals to b, is equals to 2 multiply 5. Then it is implies 5 multiply 2, 5 2 is a 10, and 2 multiply 5, 2 5 is a also 10. Then answer will be the same if we can take a multiply b or b multiply b, a answer will be same. So it is verify a multiply b is equals to b multiply a. It is verified. You can take it by another example and verify that the answer is comes same or not. And also we can you have to verify by taking example of rational number like 1 upon 2 multiply 2 upon 3 is equals to 2 upon 3 multiply 1 upon 2, answer comes same or not, you can verify it. Next is commutative property for division. It simply says a divide b or a divide b is not equals to b divide a. Let's say if we take 2 divide 1 means a divide b, where a is equals to 2 and b is equals to 1, is equals to answer will 2. For b minus b divide a, so where b is our b is 1 and a is 2, then answer will be 1 upon 2. So here it is not verified 2 divide 1 is not equals to 1 upon 2, is not verified. So we can write it a divide b is not equals to b divide a. So all of them second is associative property. We learn two property, closure property, second commutative property, and third for associative property. What is associative property? Let's say we check for addition. Now I write it by direct without any example. You can verify it by taking your own examples. A plus B plus C is equals to A plus B plus C. That means if we take B plus C and add each other, and then answer add into A, like 2 plus 3 plus 1. First add 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2. 2 plus 4 is equals to 6. And other hand side, A plus B, 2 plus 3, we can take it plus 1, answer 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, answer is 6. Answer will be same. There is no difference between the two answers. It works even if someone takes this group, or it works even if someone else take it. Whichever group you take, the answer will be the same. So this is associative property for addition. Same as for subtraction.